In this last video, we compare cell division involving meiosis with cell division involving mitosis. Meiosis is a two-division process, while mitosis is a one-division process. Both involve chromosomes condensing so that they can be moved around the cell. Both involve chromosomes lining up down the middle of the cell so that pairs of things can be split towards opposite poles of the cell. And both involve spindle fibers moving the chromosomes around. As you study, know the major phenomena that are exhibited at each stage of meiosis and at each stage of mitosis. Here's a comparison of meiosis and mitosis. In both cases, the process begins with each molecule being replicated in S phase. This produces sister chromatids that remain attached throughout much of the process. Homologous chromosomes, synapse, that is, connect in prophase 1 of meiosis, but this never happens in mitosis. Crossing over, the exchange of homologous chromosome parts also occurs during prophase 1 of meiosis and does not occur in mitosis. Crossing over can generate considerable genetic variation among the gametes that a single individual produces. Homologous chromosome pairs line up down the middle of the cell during metaphase 1 of meiosis and does not occur in mitosis. During this lineup, each homologous pair arranges or assorts itself independently of every other chromosome pair. Independent assortment also generates incredible amounts of genetic diversity. Sister chromatids line up down the middle of the cell in metaphase 2 of meiosis and in metaphase of mitosis. As mentioned in an earlier video, meiosis 2 is very similar to mitosis. Finally, the products of meiosis are 4 haploid, highly genetically variable cells. By contrast, mitosis produces 2 diploid, very much genetically identical cells. 2 different cellular reproduction processes that help us live long lives and to pass on our genes to the next generation.